Hello students, good evening everybody. Today let us start exercise 10 in indefinite integration class 12 by the method of partial fractions. We are going to see the method of partial fractions, integration, doing integration by splitting into partial fractions. Look at first question. Given integral as integral dx upon x plus 1 into x plus 2. So I am going to split the partial fractions. I am taking separately fraction 1 by x plus 1 into 1 by x plus 2. Here denominator has linear factors, non-repeated linear factors. In this case, we take a by x plus 1 plus b by x plus 2. The constants we have to find, take LCM. Whenever we have linear factors in the denominator, we can take a by x plus 1, b by x plus 2 directly. A of x plus 2 plus b of x plus 1 upon x plus 1 into x plus 2 is the LCM. So we can cancel this. So we get 1 equal to a of x plus 2 plus b of x plus 1. Now, I have to find the values of a and b. First, to get a value, I have to cancel this b. How do you cancel this b? Make this x plus 1 equal to 0. This term should become 0. That means x value should be minus 1. So, if x equal to minus 1, we get 1 equal to a into minus 1 plus 2, 1. So that implies a value will be 1. So to get the value of b, we have to make this x plus 2 equal to 0. That means x plus 2 equal to 0, then we get x equal to minus 2. Right? So if x equal to minus 2, we get 1 equal to, I want to get b value now, b of minus 2 plus 1, so minus 1. So b value minus 1. I repeat, to get the value of a, make the coefficient of b equal to 0, then we get the value of x. To get the value of b, make the coefficient of a equal to 0, then we get the value of b. Right? So now I am taking 1 by x plus 1 into x plus 2 is equal to a value how much? 1 by x plus 1 minus 1 by x plus 2. If you take LCM and simplify, we will get the same fraction. These two are called partial fractions. Now given integral I am taking. Given integral is integral dx by x plus 1 of x plus 2 is equal to integral, in the place of this I can write 1 by x plus 1, 1 by x plus 2 dx. Now split the integration. Integral 1 by x plus 1 dx minus integral 1 by x plus 2 dx. Right? So what is the integration of 1 by x plus 1? Log mod x plus 1 minus log mod x plus 2 plus c. It looks like log a minus log b. Log a by b we can write plus c. Therefore, integral dx upon x plus 1 into x plus 2 is equal to log mod x plus 1 by x plus 2 plus c. That is the solution for first problem. Right? Similarly, second question also we have partial fractions. I can take. So, already we have seen how to split the partial fractions. So, that too we are using now. So, here look at the second question, integral x upon x plus 1 into x plus 2 dx. Now, take the fraction first x by x plus 1 into x plus 2. Okay. So, here, since the denominator has non-repeated linear factors, the same thing I am taking a by x plus 1 plus b by x plus 2. We have to find the values of a and b. So, x by x plus 1 into x plus 2 is equal to, take LCM here, a of x plus 2 plus b of x plus 1 by x plus 1 into x plus 2. So, this 2 gets cancelled. Then x equal to a times x plus 2 plus b times x plus 1. Okay? Now, here you need to remember one thing. That is, to get the value of a, we have to make the coefficient of b equal to 0. Then x value should be minus 1. To get the value of a, make the coefficient of a equal to 0, then x equal to minus 2. So, first I will take, if x equal to minus 1, if x equal to minus 1, minus 1 is equal to a times minus 1 plus 2, 1. So, a value will be minus 1. If x equal to minus 2, then we will get the value of b here. Minus 2 is equal to b times minus 1. That means b equal to 2. Now, what are the partial fractions now? X by x plus 1 into x plus 2 is equal to a by minus 1 upon x plus 1 plus b means 2 by x plus 2. Now, take the integral. Integral x by x plus 1 into x plus 2 dx equal to integral 1 by x plus 1 dx plus 2 can be kept aside 2 by 1 by x plus 2 dx. So, minus 1 I am writing here. So, write the integration minus log mod x plus 1 plus 2 times log mod x plus 2 plus c. Okay. Now, further simplification, this I am writing as it is, minus log mod x plus 1, this 2 we can take into the power, that is, log of x plus 2 whole square we can write, plus c. So, it looks like log a minus log b, that I can write, log x plus 2 whole square by x plus 1 plus c, right? That is, therefore, integral x by x plus 1 into x plus 2 dx equal to log mod x plus 2 whole square upon x plus 1 plus, right? That is the end of second one. Hope it is clear. So, this exercise we are going to make partial fractions. Thank you.